morning. Last class we studied about the associative property and how it is used to solve problems very simply. In this class we are going to start with distributive property. So we can see A multiplied by B plus C will give AB plus AC. How that means? A, when you multiplied A with B plus C. This means the same. If you put a bracket, means there is a multiplication here. No need to explicitly represent that. So A multiplied by B plus C is same meaning as A into B plus C. Okay. So A, B plus C means A should be multiplied with B. So A multiplied by B, and that's a plus here. Plus, first you have to multiply A with this B, and again you have to multiply A with this C. Plus A multiplied by C. So A multiplied by B can be written as AB. Plus A multiplied by C can be written as AC. So A into B plus C will give AB plus AC. This is for addition. For subtraction, the same thing. A multiplied by B minus C. So first this A should get multiplied with this B, which is A multiplied by B. Then this minus will come here, and then this A multiplied by C. A multiplied by C. So A multiplied by B is AB minus A multiplied by C is AC. So A into B plus C equal to AB plus AC. A into B minus C equal to AB minus AC. This is the distributive property. So now we are going to solve few problems using this distributive property. The first thing is from your book. I am taking three rational numbers. A is 3 by 4 and B is 2 by 3 and C is minus 5 by 6. A is minus 3 by 4, B is 2 by 3 and C is minus 5 by 6. Now I am going to check. What I am going to check is the distribution property, which is A into B plus C equal to AB plus AC. So first I am going to check left hand side and then right hand side, and I am going to compare these two whether these are same or not. So what is left hand side is shortly written LHS A into B plus C. So first is that is equal to what is A is minus 3 by 4 multiplied by what is B 2 by 3 what is C plus what is C is minus 5 by 6. Okay, now we will solve. It is a good practice to solve whichever in the, it is always you have to solve whichever within the bracket. So this is within the bracket. First you have to solve this and you have to multiply it with minus 3 by 4. So as usual, 3 and 6 you have to take LCM because the denominators are different. The denominator are different. So 3, 6. So LCM is 6. This 2 by 3. 6. So multiplied by 2, which gives 4 by 6. So this is 4 by 6 plus minus 5 by 6. So what is 4 minus 5 plus into minus? Minus 5 by 6. That is minus 1 by 6. When the symbol are different, you have to do subtraction and put the greater number sign. So 5 minus 4 is 1. The greater number is minus. So here is minus 1 by 6. This minus 1 by 6, now we have to multiply it by minus 3 by 4. So what is A into B plus C equal to A is minus 3 by 4. That should be multiplied by B plus C. What is B plus C is minus 1 by 6. So minus 3 by 4 multiplied by minus 1 by 6. 3 ones are 6, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. This minus into minus becomes plus. 1 ones are 1 divided by 8. So the left hand side, the answer is 1 by 8. Now we have to check what is in the right hand side. What is in the right hand side is, first we have to do AB. What is that? A multiplied by B. A is minus 3 by 4 multiplied by B is 2 by 3. this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So 1 minus 1 by 2. This is AB. Then we have to do AC. A multiplied by C. What is A is minus 3 by 4 multiplied by C minus 5 by 6. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Minus into minus becomes plus. That is 5 by 8. Okay. So now we have to do AB plus AC. AB plus AC. AB plus AC. What is AB is minus 1 by 2. What is AC is plus 5 by 8. Minus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 8. Minus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 8. Now as usual, taking LCM for 2 and 8. 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, LCM is 8. So 1 minus 1 by 2 can be written as 8 minus 1 multiplied by 4 on top and bottom. This is minus 4. So minus 1 by 2 can be written as minus 4 by 8. Minus 4 by 8. 8 is here. Here also 8 is there. So we can write directly 5 by 8. That is equal to 5 minus 4 is 1 by 8. So that is equal to left hand side. You can see here. Left hand side also you will get you are getting 1 by 8. Right hand side also you are getting 1 by 8. So both left hand side and right hand side are same. We have proved the distributive property. This is the first problem you have solved. Then we are going to try few more problems using distributive property. We have to solve this using distributive property. First case, we have we check the property. Now the second, we are going to solve using distributive property. This is from your book. 7 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 12 plus 7 by 5 multiplied by 5 by 12. So this is the question. 7 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 12 plus 7 by 5 multiplied by 5 by 12. Solve, what is the solve using? The question is solve using distributive property. How to do this? Solve using distributive property. What is distributive property? A into B plus C equal to AB plus AC. So now we have to check whether the question is in the form of left hand side or right hand side. Whether the question is like this or like this. Surely we can say this is A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. So it is in the form of right hand side. So what is A here? 7 by 5. This is A. A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. What is B? According to this question, B is minus 3 by 12. And C is 5 by 12. You see here, this is A is here, 7 by 5 multiplied by B, that is minus 3 by 12 plus A. What is A is 7 by 5 multiplied by C, 5 by 12. So it is in the form of AB plus AC. The question is solve using distributive property. If the question is given in the form of AB plus AC and you have asked to solve using distributive property, we have to convert this form to this form here. A into B plus C. So A into B. So what is A here? 7 by 5 multiplied by, what is B here? Minus 3 by 12 plus 5 by 12. So that is equal to 7 by 5 multiplied by, here the denominators are same, 12, 5 minus 3 is 2. That is equal to 7 by 5 multiplied by 2 ones are 2, 2 6 are 12. 1 by 6, that is equal to 7, 6 5s are 30. So this is how we have to solve using distributive property. The question is in the form of A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. So it is in the right hand side format. If they are asked to solve using distributive property, you rearrange in the form of left hand side. That is A multiplied by B plus C.
So first I am rearranging this A multiplied by B plus C, then I am solving this. So the question is given in the form of A multiplied by B by C and ask you to solve using distributive property. You have to write in the form of AB plus AC. If the question, if you are asked to verify distributive property, you have to solve this and this left hand side and right hand side separately and you have to compare the answers. We will do one more problem using this. The same thing, 9 by 16 multiplied by 4 by 12 plus 9 by 16 multiplied by minus 3 by 9. So again it is in the form of A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. What is A here? 9 by 16. B is 4 by 12 and then C is minus 3 by 9. One thing you can do it here is A is 9 by 16. If you see B, you can solve this 1 by 3 and C is minus 1 by 3. 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12, 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. So you can change it like this. Now what is A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by B? The question is in this form. So you have to write A multiplied by B plus C. So what is A is 9 by 16 multiplied by what is B? 1 by 3 plus what is C? Minus 1 by 3. So it's going to be very simple. 9 by 16 multiplied by 1 by 3 plus into minus minus 1 by 3. That is equal to 9 by 16 multiplied by 0, which is 0. This is how we have to solve using distributive property. This is the next problem we are going to solve. This is from example 5 from your book. So here you see there is no brackets are here. Just the question is 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7 minus 1 by 14 minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 3 by 5. You have to solve using properties. So how to start with this is, first you have to know one thing. First try to put proper brackets in the proper places and then solve. And how to put brackets? The question arises is first to whether to multiply this two first or to subtract this two or to subtract this two or to multiply this. So the you should not go it in the sequence given. That is wrong. So first what should do is the preference is like this. You should put bracket according to this preference if the bracket is not given in the question paper. First is division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. So here since there is no division symbol over here, you can leave it. Then is multiplication. There is two multiplication here, one is here, another one is here. So you have to, while giving brackets, you have to give importance to the multiplication. What is, how to put bracket first? So first you have to do this, solve this multiplication first, this multiplication also. So first is 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7. This thing should be solved first. Minus 1 by 14. So now we have to, there is a multiplication here. You have to put a bracket here. Please note it, you have to put bracket like this. Minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 3 by 5. This is a. So now we can see the next step here is, here it is 2 by 7 multiplied by minus 3 by 7 minus 1 by 14 plus minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 3 by 5. So from this it is clearly, I have put a bracket over here and put a bracket here. So this is plus into minus, it's going to be the minus. There is no change in that. So by commutative property, you can rearrange it. How it will look like? 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7. Okay, plus, I'm just shifting it here, minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 3 by 5 minus 1 by 14. Just I have included bracket, one bracket over here and another bracket over here. This plus into minus is minus. No need to confuse much. This plus into minus is minus, that remains going to be the same. Okay, so here the symbol of this 3 by 7 is minus. So this plus into minus, minus, that's correct. the symbol of this 3 by 5 is plus. Here is also plus, here is also plus. Plus into plus, plus. So by commutative property, I am going to just shift from here to here and just interchanging that. So this is 2 by 5, the same is here. This minus 1 by 14 is here. This term is here. Okay. Now we can see it. This is 2 by 5, minus 3 by 7, minus 3 by 7 and 3 by 5. Now we can see that 3 by 7 is here also and here also. One thing we can do is, by minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 2 by 5. Just I am interchanging. A into B can be written as B into A. This is a commutative property for multiplication. A into B can be written as B into A. So 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7 can be written as minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 2 by 5 plus minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 3 by 5. This minus 1 by 14 you can write as it is. Now see how it look like. A multiplied B, A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. What is this? A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. What is this? Associative property, sorry, distributive property, which gives A into B plus C. Stop. So this is distributive property. A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C gives A into B plus C. Now whatever in this form, we have to write in this form. So A into B plus C equal to, what is A here? Minus 3 by 7 multiplied by, what is B here? 2 by 5. This is A, this is B and this is C. Plus, what is C here? 3 by 5. Okay. So, minus 3 by 7 multiplied by 5. 3 plus 2 is 5. So, 5, 5 get cancelled. Answer is minus 3 by 7. To this minus 3 by 7, there is another minus 1 by, now we have solved this part. There is another term is minus 1 by 14. So, from this, for this you are substituting minus 3 by 7 minus 1 by 14 is already there. So, what is 7, 14, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, LCM is 14. So, minus 3 by 7, 14, 7 twos are 14 into, here it will be, minus 6, minus 6 by 14. Instead of minus 3 by 7, I am writing minus 6 by 14, minus 1 by 14, that is equal to minus 6, minus 1 by 14, that is equal to, when the symbol are same, you have to add and put the greater number sign, since both are same, it is minus 7 by 14, that is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, so in this problem, main thing you have to keep in mind is, if in the question, if the brackets are not given, first you have to put the brackets, you have to keep it in mind, first you have to give preference for multiplication. So you should not do this subtraction of this and this and you have to multiply it by this, that is a wrong. First you have to put the bracket for multiplication here and also for here. So again you have to check the numbers. If the same numbers exist within these two brackets, then it is going to be come in the form of distributive property. So rearrange the terms according to that. And then you have to mention the property, distributive property. Mention the property, see which form it exists. In this problem, it is A into B plus A plus C. So write in the form of A into B plus C. Then whatever is remaining, you just add it to that and you will get the answer. So by this, we finished all the concepts of rational numbers, that is for chapter 1. From next class, we are going to solve with exercise problems. Thank you.